No pulse, he's not breathing.
Start CPR while I secure his airway.
Exercise has all sorts of proven health benefits, and now we've got a new one to add to that list, curing diseases. Joining us this morning to talk about that and more is the Desert's Own Dr. Ruth Anderson. Good morning, doctor. Thanks for waking up early. So your book, really interesting idea, concept behind it, because we think of exercise, at least I do, as kind of a maintenance thing, like you're maintaining your health, but you actually believe and shown that it can help cure diseases. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, actually, I didn't show it. I mean, this book is a medically based guide, and it tells you, you're right, maintain or prevent disease. That's the best use of exercise. Yeah. But there's a couple diseases, if you know what to do, if you do the right exercise program, science has shown you can beat hypertension. 75% of the people can. Mm-hmm. And if you combine exercise with weight loss, yeah, you can cure your type 2 diabetes.
So we're talking the ones, the diseases that can really help it out with, you're talking diabetes, also arthritis, you mentioned it can help that as well.
There's six biggies.
Okay.
Six biggies in America and six biggies that the book tackles. There's heart disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, osteoporosis, arthritis, which is important here, and low back pain, which is important everywhere. That's the number one complaint.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, we have a list of some of the different benefits that you can get from exercise, things that can help you out. One is it increases the anti-inflammatory blood factors. It also lowers blood pressure, right?
That's right. After your first exercise session, well, 75% of the people get a blood pressure lowering effect. It's called post-exercise hypotension, if you want the real term. And again, it's scientifically shown. The people who have the highest blood pressures get the most benefit.
Really?
So and you can do it. It lasts up to 22 hours. So if you do the right program, you know, and it's not the right amount, kind of bicep curls, it's the right kind of walking and the number of minutes and intensity and all of that. If you do the right program on a regular basis, you're going to come down off your meds, get rid of all those side effects, and potentially stop.
You know, you just mentioned the right program. What are some exercises that people can do that, because we were talking before, and it's not like you have to go to the gym and bench press 200 pounds to get the benefits, right?
No. What you want to do when you have high blood pressure, or to fight it, you know, if I say it runs in your family, is you're going to use weights, but instead of using as much as you can and throwing your form out, lower weights, and you're going to do slow, controlled reps. Most important
so you're breathing.
Is to breathe out
so is
while
it,
you lift.
Is it lower weights and form just so it's more of an aerobic thing? Or
well,
is it
no,
just...
no. The slow, controlled. See, look at those veins pop. That slow control, that's right, recruits a lot more muscle fibers. You actually get better training, okay?
So more muscles
so
and fibers
more muscle fibers, which
more
means more growth, and so you get better results, but you're not raising your pressure to sky high levels.
So maybe the myth that you have to be feel like you're working really hard, not necessarily true to get the benefits, right?
That's right. You have to work well. Diabetes, type
which is also called type 2 or adult onset diabetes, is one disease that you can control, you can even obliterate with the right exercise program.